some of life's frustrations in a constructive manner. It's happening out west on a racetrack where the legal speed limit is unlimited and it's kid versus cop. Here's ABC's Greg Dodd. This summer, when the officers of the Salt Lake City Police depart for patrol, there's one kind of lawbreaker they won't have to chase. Yes, there is still drag racing here in Salt Lake City. But every Wednesday night at the Bonneville Raceway, at speeds up to 115 miles per hour, the cops encourage the kids to race against them. Why did you challenge a cop?
Well, I want to see one very clear on the drag racing on the freeway.
That's right. The cops put their patrol car on the line. It's a 1976 454-cubic inch beat-up Chevy Nova, which for 4 years was on the streets chasing kids until this program called Race a Cop, the kids like to call it Beat a Cop, got started.
We'd rather race them on the crew track than have to chase them on the streets, probably said.
Three cops, a patrolman, a burglary alarm enforcement officer, and a sex crime detective work on their own time and with donated parts, no tax dollars, to encourage kids to race legally and safely. And it seems to work.
I had a lot of tickets for federation at the drag, and I haven't had any since. It's a lot better place to come do what you like to do.
Does it work with you?
Yeah, I don't work on the thing anymore, so I'm paid. I get to suck in with the kids and let them know that I'm a real person, and they don't always have to be afraid of us, afraid that we're going to give them a ticket.
The primary purpose of Race a Cop has been achieved. According to one officer here, drag racing on the streets of Salt Lake City is not even a noticeable problem anymore. Greg Dodd, ABC News, Salt Lake City.